Today's job is going to be a little, I guess it's, you call it dredging. I got a concrete lined like ditch or swell or whatever. It's kind of like a retention area here at our local Lowe's, but as you can see, it's pretty much full of water, trash, and weeds and junk like that. So I'm basically just going to start at that end because I can, got the truck and the loader and everything parked down here, and I can kind of pull everything this way and probably load the truck about where I'm sitting at. And then we'll kind of reshape it, and then I'll have to seed and straw on both sides of it. But I gotta get all this sediment off here and kind of get it straightened back up. And then the other ditch I've got, you can't even see it from here, but it's out in the front. I gotta put a small dissipator pad at the end of a kind of a concrete deal like this right here, which they didn't ask for it here. I guess that concrete does run the entire length or distance of this ditch. There's another culvert that comes out from underneath that road. It's almost completely covered. But then out front, I got to do a dissipator pad and then regrade that ditch. There's a concrete drain box up there at the front. We got to do a little bit of touching up around, but yeah, should be an easy, fairly simple little job. It may take me today and part of tomorrow by the time I scrape all this off, and then like I said, go get the seed and straw blower and get that cleaned up. But let's get to it and see how much of a muddy mess this is going to make. My tailgate doesn't quite seal up the best, so I'm gonna have to try to, I don't know, find a little drier stuff to put towards the back, kind of like Chris does, but it doesn't look like anything is going to be dry. This thing has been silted in for like as long as I can remember coming over here. But yeah, for as long as I can remember, this ditch, I don't think I've ever seen it cleaned out before. Or if I have, I've never paid attention to it or anything like that, so. But my plan is to come down here and gonna try to start at that end so that water can be draining. And maybe it'll kind of dry out. I'm just piling this stuff on the edge and I'll kind of, I don't know, pull it out a little more and work my way down to where I'm gonna load the truck. Hopefully some of it'll kind of drain down in this ditch, but because yeah, I'm gonna make a mess on that parking lot and then the road going to the dump site. Be drained, which it is draining that way, just not very quick. working out pretty good. I mean, it's not bad. It's probably better than trying to push it all down at the end and use the loader. I'm not making as many trips down there, but as you can tell, my excavator and dump truck are pretty nasty. Even the whole top of the dump truck, you dump some of this stuff in there and it splatters everywhere. And that is one good part about it not raining right now. That whole side of the retention area is like dry. It's almost like driving on concrete. So I was worried about the truck sinking, and I was kind of worried about putting this in there for all the water and junk running out of the tailgate on the parking lot up there. So, which there is a lot of water running out of the tailgate. I've had two people tell me that driving down the road when they're, I guess they're behind me at the stoplight that's pouring out of there. So they gave me the old "you're number one." Luckily, it's an extremely short haul from here. There's only two stoplights I gotta run through. But it's not like I could really just pile this stuff up and let it dry out there. I kinda gotta have this done by the end of the week. Which it should be another day or so, have everything done and seed and straw, but it's my 15th wedding anniversary with Ms. Amin, so we are actually taking off on Thursday to go to Kansas City for a couple days. So I'm only got Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday to work on this. So this is probably going to be the worst section of it, because like I said, the front ditch is dry. Start this morning, I had to go dig the little 16 foot long frost footing at the basement job. Those guys are over there forming it up. But I was happy to know that the house did fit in the crawl space in the basement, so at least my overdig and stuff was all good. Company was there putting the water meter in, so I kind of looked at with the builder on that, on routing the water line and everything. And so, it's more stuff that needs to be done.